Why have you been spying on me?
Don't be cranky about it. We have to ensure that she stays in the Chancellor's seat.
Who is we? Emperor.
You have me confused with someone else. I'm Philippa Georgiou, retired captain of the USS Saint-Jean, now Starfleet security consultant. Children of parasites, ungrateful, inconvenient. I had to find someone else to feed mine, or I would have gotten nothing done.
I will consider that advice. Thank you for your help.
Gratitude is premature. As long as the disemboweled leader of House Kor is splattered on your floor.
He took our child, tried to force her to abdicate. We were defending ourselves. Kolshaw killed your uncle. It's an eye for an eye.
I need a word with the Chancellor. Every minute you remain here, your counselors must reorganize their tiny male brains to rationalize why it isn't them standing on the dais. They will assume that all your decisions are Tyler's. He is a liability. Can you kill him? I had to ask. He is a liability too. You can't show weakness when it comes to either one of them.
I will not choose between the Chancellorship and my son and his father.
I told you what I am here to protect. I am not giving you a choice. I disabled the cameras for 60 seconds, so listen closely. Your instincts are correct, Michael. That machine is a memory extractor. It will destroy your brother's mind.
Why should I believe you?
Leland is just a puppet following orders. And I didn't think you want your brother's blood on your hands.
So you're telling me this out of the goodness of your heart?
No, the goodness of yours. I know so much more about you than you can imagine. But that's for another time. Right now, you're going to attack me, then rescue Spock, which is good for you. And that will make Leland look bad, which is good for me. 10 seconds, Michael. So, what will you do?
Trying to make it look good?
Not that. Once more. With feeling.
Time via micro wormholes. But wormholes are inherently unstable, so the Angel needs to hold them open or she won't be able to get home again. And as I understand it, to keep the wormhole open, the suit generates a membrane, a protective layer that travels with her. And one end stays attached to her starting point in the future. An anchor, when she wants to go home, it snaps her back like a rubber band.
Our phase discriminators will hold the Angel in stasis beams, so the membrane can't snap her back. And then we'll lower her to a platform where an electromagnetic pulse will shut down the time crystal that powers her suit.
And then we raise the containment field, and that will hold her here for as long as we want. And then we can question her, and nothing from the future will be able to reach us, right? What's that look on your face?
I was thinking you may be smarter than the Stamets I knew. You're also much more neurotic. Have you considered medication?
Based on my calculations, the phase discriminators should function properly. The problem is...
Hey, Tilly, is Admiral Cornwell here? I thought she might be...
Yeah, what? No, she's not. No, but it is, it's great, so great that you're here.
Please, your wide-eyed attempt to release this fabulous male tension is a buskill. You never learned to relish a little discomfort, Red? Who raised you?
My mom, but she wasn't around a lot.
Stop talking. You said there was a problem, Pa?
Yes, with the phase discriminators. We'd need the equivalent of 12 warp cores to generate enough energy to run them. And if we can even locate that much power, it will be almost impossible to control.
Not for you. In fact, we don't need warp cores. One of the Project Daedalus testing sites was on Issa 4.
Yes, I read about that place. So much deuterium. We can use it to create a plasma reactor to power up our phase discriminators. And then, snap, we have our mouse.
You are savvier than he was.
You do know that he's gay, right?
Don't be so binary. In my universe, he was pansexual, and we had DEFCON level fun together. And you too, Poppy.
Did you just call me Poppy?
Well, in my universe, and pretty much any universe I can possibly imagine, I'm gay, and so is he.
Of course you are. I'm glad we all see what's right in front of us. And now, if you'll excuse me, I need to talk to Captain Pike about setting a course for Issa 4. What just happened?
No! Mom, stay down!
Come on, I got you. I got you. Come on. Okay.
Captain, we cannot stop the data transfer.
How much data has he downloaded now?
45%, 46%. The transfer speed is increasing.
If we each shoot one of the discs, the power disruption will release the containment field.
You have to let me go, Michael. It's the only way each of us has a chance to survive. I'll find you, Mom. It'll be okay. I love you. I love you too, baby girl.
Ready. Now.
Unable to locate sphere data.
I know where it is. Leland, you look well.
For a couple of batteries and a data core stuffed in a meat sack.
Kind of like an AI sausage.
Ew.
Women, stop talking.
Remember this?
It's a quantum signal amplifier. I gave it to you to transfer the sphere data to my ship. I assume you're holding it now to demonstrate.
Why, you won't find the sphere data anywhere here.
Where can I access my data?
Your data?
So many fun ways to answer that question.
Failure. Local gravity systems failure.
and I hate boring!
Fast access to the ship's two most valuable assets. The data is in the Spore console.
You think this cage will hold me?
With the tantrum already. Let's end this now, shall we? You should know, I've magnetized the spore cube. Enjoy.
This does not end here.
Actually, it does. And it's going to hurt. And I'd like to hear you scream now.
Ah! Ah!